皆さんこんばんは。クロージングセッションにようこそ。
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the closing session.
原発ゼロ自然エネルギー100世界会議はどのようにご参加いただいたでしょうか。
We hope that you have enjoyed and had a meaningful time today in the Global Conference for a Nuclear-Free Renewable Energy Future.
ここでは、ドイツ連邦政府の原子力委員長である方であったり、韓国の市民団体環境財団から、メッセージをいただいたり、また、この主催である現地連の吉原さんから、ご挨拶をいただいたり、そのような流れで、進めていきたいと思います。
In this closing session, we will also have the great opportunity of messages, especially from a member of the German Parliament, a representative of today's organizers, and also the civil society organization in Korea, the Green Foundation.
またですね、今日一日福島から現状を伝えてくれたバーチャルツアーのチームともつなぎたいと思っています。
We will also be connecting to the team who have been coordinating all day today a virtual tour live from Fukushima.
このクロージングの進行を務めさせていただきますのはピースボートの松村真澄と申します。
I am 松村真澄 and I will be chairing this closing session.
そして通訳に入っているのは同じくピースボートのメリー・ジョイスです。
And the interpretation is provided by Mary Joyce.
そしてですね、もう一人、早稲田大学の学生でできること会議の共同代表でいらっしゃいます青柳雄大さんを呼びたいと思います。一緒に司会でよろしくお願いいたします。
And also chairing today, we will be having Aoyagi Yudai joining, who is a student at Waseda University and co-representative of the What We Can Do meeting.
Yudai さん、ちょっと自己紹介とどんなことをしているか教えていただけますか?
Yudai, can you please introduce yourself?
すみません。はい、皆さんこんにちは。現在、早稲田大学に在学しております、できること会議共同代表の Aoyagi Yudai です。
So good evening, everybody. My name is Yudai. I am a student at Waseda University and also co-representative of the What We Can Do meeting.
はい、できることを今会議しようというコンセプトのもと、社会問題に対して何ができるのかを話し合う場所を提供し、また若者向けのプロジェクト支援を主に行っております。
So we are doing with this project looking at how we can create spaces, platforms for people to come together and talk about social issues, also provide support for different youth-led projects and have this space together to come.
はい。また、ジェンダー、セクシャリティ、環境を軸に学生として社会に対しての啓発活動や政治活動等をしております。
We're also involved in different education and political activities as young people, as students, with focus on gender, sexuality, and the environment.
はい、本日はどうぞよろしくお願いいたします。
Thanks very much for today.
はい、震災が起きた10年前のこの日、僕はまだ小学6年生でしたが、鮮明に当時のことを覚えています。
I was actually just in the sixth grade in elementary school on this day 10 years ago when the devastating earthquake and tsunami struck, but I can remember that day so vividly.
10年前からの教訓を今日の私たち、そして日本社会はどれほど変化を生み出す力とシフトできたのか、この会議をきっかけに非常に考えさせられました。
And this conference today was really a great opportunity to reflect back upon 10 years ago, the lessons that we have learned, how Japanese society has managed to change and shift since then as well.
皆さんも今日一日、特に原子力エネルギーから自然エネルギーにシフトしていくために様々なヒントを得れたと思います。
I'm sure that everybody joining today could gain many different hints of how we can truly shift from nuclear energy to renewable energy.
クロージングでは、まずそういった具体的な取り組みをドイツの政府側の立場として推進してこられたドイツ連邦議会の環境自然保護原子安全委員会委員長のシルビア・コッティング・ウールさんのビデオメッセージをご覧ください。
So first to share a voice from overseas, we will be having a very special video message from Ms. Sylvia Kotting-Uhl, a member of the German Parliament and chairperson of the Committee for the Environment, Nature Conservation and Nuclear Safety.
Dear participants of the conference, thank you for giving me the opportunity of saying a few words about the status of nuclear phase-out in Germany and Europe. Following the serious accident in Fukushima, the German Bundestag reached a cross-party agreement on the nuclear phase-out, which the Greens and Social Democrats had already decided in 2001, and which was reversed by the Christian Democrats and Liberals in 2010. Today, only 6 of 19 commercially used nuclear power units are still in operation. The last one will be shut down in 2022. The decision was made because hundreds of thousands demonstrated on the streets of Germany against nuclear power. Today we know that not only nuclear power, but also the climate crisis threatens mankind and becomes an irresponsible legacy for future generations. And once again, it is the people on the streets who forced the German government to act. Hundreds of thousands of children and young people followed Greta Thunberg's appeal and called for the phase-out of coal-fired power generation in Europe and other parts of the world. In July 2020, the decision was taken to phase out coal by 2038. We Greens do not regard this coal phase-out to be ambitious enough. But all polls indicate that Greens will be in government after the 2021 elections, and then we will adapt the coal phase-out to the necessary climate protection. Peace in the world needs climate protection just as much as the abandonment of nuclear power. Energy production for peace are the renewables. Despite our nuclear phase-out, however, the nuclear risk still exists for Germany, as dangerous nuclear power plants near the German border are still in operation. Katernom in France, Betznau in Switzerland, and Temelin in the Czech Republic are just a few examples. The German Greens have long been calling on the German government to walk towards a European nuclear phase-out, particularly in the context of the German EU presidency last year. But Germany did not seize this opportunity, and now supporters of nuclear power in Europe are trying to revive the old dangerous technology. France, with its historical nuclear industry, and Eastern countries who reject the potential of renewables, are trying to convince the European Commission that this is the only solution to reduce CO2 emissions. They want nuclear power to qualify as a green investment and as a green source of hydrogen in the hope of retrieving investors who ran away from tremendous losses. But not only is nuclear power absolutely unnecessary to reach carbon neutrality in Europe, it even actively stands in its way. There are two main reasons for this. First, the chain of uranium extraction, enrichment, construction of nuclear power plants, and final storage produces considerable CO2 emissions, along with a variety of non-recyclable radioactive wastes. With 104 grams of CO2 for 1 kilowatt hour, nuclear scores poorly as compared to wind and photovoltaic power. Second, NPPs generate baseload power and are inflexible. Baseload electricity clogs the grids, causes costs for avoiding bottlenecks, and prevents the intelligent management of demand from distributed generators. To put it in a simple term, nuclear power cannot be a partner of renewables. In order to be taken seriously with its nuclear phase-out, Germany needs to complete it. Germany is continuing uranium enrichment and the production of nuclear fuel despite its nuclear phase-out, thus ensuring that the nuclear carousel continues to spin. It exports enriched uranium to Russia and thereby deliberately breaks EU law. This must be stopped right away. Last but not least, Germany still invests hundreds of millions in nuclear fusion research, which will also produce waste and will be coming too late to help achieve carbon neutrality, assuming it really does come one day. This waste of money is to be stopped, both at national and EU level. I would also like to mention the search for a deep geological repository in Germany, as this is an achievement we can be proud of. The attempt to push through the Gorleben Salt Dome as the German repository for high radioactive waste in the 1970s and the subsequent storm of protest have shown that it is impossible to select such a repository without a comprehensive scientific analysis and well-planned public participation. A commission consisting of representatives from science, civil society, and politics met for 2 years and then made its recommendations on how a fair and integrative site selection process could look like. In 2017, these recommendations were implemented in a law. It turned to be a very green law, The site selection process must be comparative, science-based, transparent, participating, and learning. In the end, the most suitable site for a final repository for highly radioactive waste should be found. Now, the whole process is in place and is being implemented. The existing geological data has been collected and analyzed. In September 2020, a first broad selection of sites has been published, and a large video conference was held to discuss the results with all those interested. It is part of a set of four public symposiums to raise awareness and foster participation before the next selection round takes place. A special body has been created to ensure that the law is implemented in all its aspects. It's called the National Monitoring Board. It is made up of high-ranking personalities as well as so-called random citizens and monitors transparency and participation in every search phase. The law also found broad consensus in the Bundestag. The consensus is important because the search will take many decades. To find a place for the most possible storage of nuclear waste is complex and very expensive. In the end, nuclear power is not also the most dangerous, but also the most expensive power. It is the task of our generation to save future generations from the consequences of the greatest error in industrial history. All people who are aware of this task must work together in Germany, in Japan, and all over the world. Thank you.
ありがとうございました。シルビア・コッティング・ウールさんの映像をご覧いただきました。
Thank you very much for that video message from Sylvia Cottingwood.
シルビアさんは10年前の事故の直後、5月頃ですね、いち早く日本にもいらっしゃって、その翌年に行われた脱原発世界会議にもご参加いただいています。
And Sylvia was actually very early to visit Fukushima and Japan following the disaster 10 years ago and also attended the Global Conference for a Nuclear Power-Free World held the following year.
このコロナがなければ今回も10周年ということで日本に来たいというふうに言っていたと伺っています。
And we understand that if it were not for the COVID-19 pandemic, we're sure that she would be here sharing this moment with us in Japan today as well.
それではドイツの政治側からのメッセージを聞いていただきましたが、次はメッセージでは市民社会からどんなことができるのか、韓国の環境財団のチェ・ヨル代表のビデオメッセージをご覧ください。
So we've just had a message from a politician in Germany, of course, and next we will be hearing about citizens' power in regards to this with a special message from Choi Yol of the Korean Green Foundation.
안녕하세요. 환경운동가 Choi Yol입니다. 제가 환경 문제에 관심을 가진 것은 1976년 제가 옥중에서 앞으로 나가서 무엇을 할 것인가 그런 생각을 하다가 환경 문제를 택했습니다. 그게 꼭 45년 전이죠. 그리고 40년 전에 한국 최초로 환경단체를 만들어서 지금까지 활동을 하고 있습니다. 저는 환경운동을 하면서 원자력에 대해서도 관심을 가지게 되었죠. 그런데 우리나라 한국의 환경교육이나 원자력 문제는 원자력의 일방적인 홍보를 중심으로 하게 됐습니다. 한 예를 들면은 원자력은 공해가 없고 안전하고 그리고 가격이 싸다 이런 식으로 우리가 교육을 받았습니다. 그렇지만 저는 환경운동을 하면서 전 세계 원전 반대의 흐름도 알고 또 거기서 활동하는 사람들도 많이 만나면서 특히 지금도 기억나는 것은 1983년 미국의 멀티내셔널 모니터라는 잡지의 편집장이 와서 한국은 원자력 판매의 천국이다. 특히 미국 뉴욕타임즈의 큰 보도가 난 것을 보면서 아 이게 원자력이 정치자금의 자금줄이 되는구나 이런 생각을 가지게 됐습니다. 그러다가 1986년 4월 26일 인류 최대의 사고인 체르노빌 원전 폭발 사고가 났게 된 거죠. 그래서 굉장히 많은 사람이 생명을 잃고 지금도 반경 30km 안에는 사람이 살지 못하는 지역으로 남아 있습니다. 그래서 저는 그 후에 우리나라에서 최초로 만들어진 고리 원전 지금은 가장 원전도 많고 또 원전 반경 안에는 30km 안에는 약 300만 명이라는 사람들이 살고 있습니다. 그런데 거기도 마찬가지로 원전 주변에 있는 주민들에게 왜곡된 자료, 왜곡된 홍보를 통해서 주민들은 그 안에 원자력 교회가 만들어지고 원자력 정육점이 만들어지고 핵강 아파트가 들어서는 그런 심각한 상황이 된 거죠. 그렇게 해서 한국의 원전 반대 운동, 특히 신규 원전 반대 운동을 저는 적극적으로 참여했습니다. 그러다가 지금부터 꼭 10년 전인 2011년 3.11, 어떻게 보면은 인류 최대의 참사, 일본의 쓰나미를 통해서 원전 세계가 폭발하고, 그래서 그 현장을 저는 직접 여러 차례 갔습니다. 반경 10km 안에까지도 들어가 보고, 거기에 있는 흙을 전부 다 5cm씩 이렇게 모아가지고 엄청나게 큰 검정 포대에 쌓인 것을 이렇게 보게 된 거죠. 그렇게 보면서 핵과 원전은 인류와 함께 할 수 없다. 그런 생각을 하게 됐습니다. 그러면 우리는 도대체 무엇으로 전기를 생산하고 무엇으로 에너지를 쓸 것인가? 이런 생각을 더 하게 되면서 지금 현재 우리가 많이 쓰고 있는 석탄, 석유, 가스는 당시에 가격은 쌌지만은 미세먼지가 나오고 또 온실가스가 나오고 석유를 합성해서 만드는 석유화학물질로 많은 화학물질이 나오고 특히 플라스틱이나 비닐을 통해서 우리는 결국 탄소 문명으로 인해서 우리 인간이 살 수 없는 이런 상황으로 지금 막 달리고 있다고 봅니다. 그래서 이제 이 문제를 해결하기 위해서 나온 것이 자연을 이용한 에너지다. 우리가 말하는 재생에너지요. 그래서 태양광, 그다음에 바람, 풍력, 지열, 바이오, 수력, 이런 걸 가지고 결국은 이제 할 수밖에 없다. 이런 식으로 해서 많은 노력을 해왔습니다. 그런데 최근 10년 동안에 많은 노력과 기술 혁신, 대량 생산 이런 걸 통해서 태양광 경우에는 지난 10년 동안에 100원짜리가 지금은 11원으로 89%가 떨어지고 풍력은 100원 코스트가 지난 10년 동안에 70%가 떨어져서 30원이 되고 그 대신에 원전은 여러 차례 대형 사고가 나면서 안전에 대한 시스템을 갖추기 위해서 원전은 도리어 지난 10년 동안에 26%가 가격이 상승이 된 거죠. 그런 걸로 보면은 이제는 태양광과 풍력을 중심으로 해야 된다고 봅니다. 그렇지만 태양광과 풍력은 바람이 불 때도 있고 또 저녁에는 햇빛이 들어오지 않기 때문에 이것을 저장하는 시스템을 만들어야 된다. 그 저장 시스템은 저는 그린 수소라고 생각합니다. 거기서 남아있는 전기를 그린 수소로 전환해서 결국은 우리가 2050년에는 탄소 제로인 사회를 만들 필요가 있지 않나 이런 생각이 듭니다. 특히 동아시아, 동북아시아, 한국과 일본, 중국 여기는 세계에서 가장 인구가 밀집되어 있고 그 대신에 과학기술이 굉장히 발달한 나라입니다. 그렇기 때문에 한중일이 정치적으로는 여러 가지 갈등이 있지만 지구촌의 환경 문제, 인류의 생존을 위해서는 3개국이 연대해서 기술 교류도 하고 해서 가장 빠른 좋은 모델을 만들고 그 모델을 제3세계에 많이 확산시켜서 2050년에는 탄소 제로 사회를 만드는 것이 필요하지 않나 이런 생각이 듭니다. 그래서 저는 3.11 대재앙 이것이 우리 인류에게 엄청난 충격을 주고 피해를 가져왔지만 또 우리 인류가 지속 가능한 발전을 만드는데 도리어 전화위복이 될 수 있는 그 역할을 우리 동아시아에서 해야 되지 않나 생각합니다. 저는 앞으로 한국을 비롯해서 다른 나라의 탄력 그리고 신재생에너지를 만드는데 힘을 합칠 것을 약속드립니다. 특히 이다 제나리 선생이나 일본에 있는 탄핵운동가 또 신재생 문제에 대해서 적극적으로 노력하는 분들에게 코로나로 직접 만나지 못하기 때문에 이렇게 인사드립니다. 여러분 힘내서 화이팅!
ご覧いただきありがとうございました。韓国の環境財団からチェ・ヨルさんの映像でした。
So thank you very much for that message from Che Yol of the Korea Green Foundation.
はい。それでは、福島の皆さんとつなぎたいと思います。
So we would next like to connect with the team in Fukushima at the moment.
今日一日、福島の方々のご案内で名所を回り、現状や今思うことについて話してこられたと思うのですが、3月11日を終えようとしている今、どのように感じていらっしゃるでしょうか。福 福島の皆さん。
So today we had a program for a virtual tour all day from Fukushima, hearing from local citizens about the current situation and their feelings today on March 11th. So we'll pass over to them now.
皆さんこんばんは。ピースボートの川崎明と申します。今日は一日ですね、福島バーチャルツアーということで、FOE ジャパンとピースボートで協力しまして、福島県内、飯舘、双葉、そして、大熊、富岡と回ってまいりました。今双葉町の東日本大震災原子力災害伝承館の前におります。
Good evening, everyone. My name is Akira Kawasaki from Peace Boat. Today we conducted a virtual tour of Fukushima in cooperation with FOE Japan and Peace Boat. We visited many different places within Fukushima Prefecture, including Itate Village, Futaba, Okuma, and Tomioka. Currently, we are in front of the Great East Japan Earthquake and Nuclear Disaster Memorial Museum, located in Futaba.
今日の午後ずっとですね、こちらにいらっしゃいます高村美春さん、この伝承館で語り部をなさっているお一人ですけども、私たちのツアーをナビゲートしてくださいまして、そしてこの原発災害というものは全く終わっていないんだという、そういうお話をしてくださいました。
So this entire afternoon we were joined by Miharu Takamura, who is a storyteller here at the Memorial Museum, and she has helped to navigate us through Fukushima, and she has reminded us that this disaster has not yet ended.
この世界会議を締めくくるにあたりましてですね、高村美春さんからお言葉いただきたいと思います。
はい。So we'd like to hear from Ms. Takamura now, to end this World Convention.
今ご紹介に預かりました高村美春と申します。今日は一日本当にありがとうございました。
As introduced, my name is Miharu Takamura, and so thank you so much for having me today. はい。
実は今までここで、追悼の花火が上がっておりました。今日3月11日は地震、津波でたくさんの方がお亡くなりになりました。この今私たちがいるこの場所でもお亡くなりになりました。
Actually, a few minutes prior to this broadcast, there were fireworks in to memorialize the people that passed away on this day, March 11th. Many people passed away because of the earthquake and subsequent tsunami. And soeven here where we're standing now, many people passed away.
そしてここは悲劇の場所でもあります。それは、このすぐ3キロ先にあります福島第一原子力発電所が爆発をした。そしてここで行方不明になった方たちの捜索が行われなかった。ずっと私たちはこの10年その思いを、持ち続けています。
This was also the scene of another disaster that took place following the tsunami and earthquake. The Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant exploded, which meant that we were not able to search for the people that were missing after the tsunami. And so we've carried these feelings with us for the past 10 years.
今、福島第一原子力発電所は廃炉に向けて、様々な、世界から、知恵や、人材、そういったものが集まって行われてはおりますが、私たち住民は本当に廃炉にできるのかと日々、実は不安がっております。
The nuclear, Daiichi nuclear power plant is heading towards decommissioning, and people from around the world have gathered to bring knowledge so that we can move this forward. But at the same time, the residents, us residents in this area, we question if this is really possible, and we live with this concern every day.
原発の廃炉、そして今処理水と言われているトリチウム水の問題、そして子どもたちへの健康問題、放射線、そして、帰還困難区域にこれから解除となり人が戻るか戻らないか、さまざまな問題が山積みとなっております。
Aside from the issues regarding decommissioning the power plant, we also have the so-called treated water which contains tritium. We have many issues around the health of our childrenradiation related issues, the difficult to return zones, the evacuation will be lifted in those areas, and so there is the concern of whether or not people will begin to return to these areas. So as you can see, we have so many issues that we still need to deal with.
まだ何にも終わっていません。終わっていないのに、もう終わったかのように私たちは今ここで苦しんでおります。
So as you can see, nothing has ended, nothing has been resolved, but people are trying to make it seem like it has ended, and so we are still suffering here.
それでも、その苦しみの中でも、世界の人たち、日本の人たちがたくさん私たちのことを気にかけてくださっています。
Despite all of this suffering, we can also see that many people around the world and many people within Japan are really care about us.
震災で本当にたくさんの方を亡くし、苦しみ、悲しみがありました。
As a result of this disaster, we lost many people and there was a lot of sadness and suffering.
それでもその中から私たちは希望を考えて、ずっと今おります。でも本当の希望ってまだつかめてないような気がします。
Despite all this sadness and suffering, we were able to carry on because we had hope, but I don't think that we've really found true hope yet.
このたくさんの方が亡くなった沿岸地で、こういう話をするのは申し訳ないかもしれませんが、亡くなった方たちがたくさん教えてくださいました。
So we're standing here in the coastal region where so many people passed away, and I don't know if it's correct to say this, but I think that the people that passed away taught us so much.
私たちは生かされてます。そしてその生と死の間に今いることを、亡くなった方たちが教えてくださいました。
We were given the privilege to keep on living after the disaster, and so right now I think that we're living between life and death, and I think the people that passed away really taught us so many things.
まだ終わってません。
Nothing has ended yet. People of the world and people in Japan, I ask you to remember us. We are living here and we are keeping on moving forward. But there are times when we want to give up. And so we ask that you keep on caring about us, you keep on watching us, and that you don't forget us.
亡くなった方たちももちろん、そして私たちのことも、どこか心の片隅でも構いません。忘れないで。ずっと見続けてください。それがここに住む私たちの願いだと思っております。今日は本当にありがとうございました。
I ask that you keep on remembering the memories of the people that passed away and keep caring about the people that are living here. Even if it's just in the part of your heart, please don't forget us. Thank you so much for today.
河村さん、本当にもありがとうございました。ありがとうございます。忘れないでくださいという言葉の中に今日一日この福島を回らせてもらって、伝承館もそうなんですけども、たくさんのメディアの車が取りに来ていると。でそれは当然今日この日を取りに来ているんですけども、明日からは報道しないかもしれないんですよね。で今日私たちこの世界会議オンラインで行いまして、今日はみんな見たわけです。私たちも見たわけです。しかし明日以降忘れて他のことにですね、忙しくなってしまって、ここで起きている現実をから目をそらしてしまうかもしれない、そういう危険性というのは私たち一人一人にもあるんだというふうに思うんですよね。ですので今日この世界会議をきっかけにしまして、これからも考え続け、つながり続ける、そういうふうにしていきたいというふうに思います。で今日このツアーを準備しました FOE ジャパンの方ではですね、福島見える化プロジェクトということで、福島の方々のいろんな証言をビデオにして、ホームページに載せて、各国語に翻訳をしているというのもございますので、ぜひホームページの方で検索してご覧いただきたいというふうに思いますし、今回のつながりを生かして、今後ともですね、活動してまいりたいというふうに思います。
Today we were traveling around various parts of Fukushima, and I want to talk about the words that you said, don't forget. We saw many vehicles for the media that were here today, but I think that they were here because of this day that is significant. And so tomorrow there may not be many cars here to report, online the media may not report about us anymore. And obviously us as well, people watching and us here in Fukushima, we may forget, we may move on to our lives tomorrow and get busy. And so I encourage everyone to keep remembering about this issue and keep fighting for this issue. Today's tour is in part by FOE Japan, and on their website they have a project called the Mieruka Project, which has many testimony of people in Fukushima that are living the reality of Fukushima, and it has been translated into many languages, so I encourage you to check out their website as well. So let's keep on continuing to cover this issue. The memorial fireworks have picked up again. We need to move away from this area.
まあ、打ち上げ花火という言葉がありますけれども、本当にそれに終わらせずに、つながりをしていきたいと思います。
So sometimes fireworks signify the end, but let's not forget about this issue and let's keep on fighting. Thank you.
で、この福島からのこのメッセージをですね、吉川美智さんの通訳でお伝えしました。Thank you very much for your
interpretation, 吉川。
ありがとうございます。
Thank you.
それでは東京にお戻ししたいと思います。
So we'll return it back to people in Tokyo.
ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much.
はい、福島の皆さん、ありがとうございました。
So thank you so much to everybody in Fukushima today.
はい、福島での戦いはまだ終わっていなくて、そこは福島の人たち、災害された方たちの問題だけではなく、私たち全員の問題、そして責任であるということを改めて感じました。
So of course, the struggle and the ongoing situation in Fukushima continues today, but it's so important, as we have just heard, for us to remember that this is not only an issue for the people of Fukushima, but indeed this is something that each and every one of us shares responsibility for as well.
私たち若い世代も、こう、次の世代にも引き継ぐぞと思いを持って、責任を持って、日々過ごしていきたいなというふうに思います。
And as youth as well, looking at how we can carry that responsibility on to and as the next generation, I want to keep that with us also.
はい、最後に今日一日を振り返って、現地連会長の吉原剛さんから締めくくりのメッセージをいただきたいと思います。
So to reflect on the day's program that we had in overall today, we will now be hearing from Mr. Yoshiwara Tsuyoshi, who is the chair of Genji Ren, today's organizers.
吉原さん、お願いいたします。
Over to you, Mr. Yoshiwara.
はい、皆さん、こんにちは。今日は朝から本当に一日充実した、セッションが続きまして、私もですね、本当に、いろんな方々のご意見を聞いて、感銘を受けました。もちろん、日本国内、はい、失礼しました。
So good afternoon or good evening, everybody. I think we had a very full program today with many different sessions. And personally, also, I was able to hear and learn so much from the many different perspectives that were shared.
はい、特に日本国内だけでなく、外国の方々からさまざまな世界の状況を教えていただき、日本が残念ながらいかに遅れているか、世界の常識といかにかけ離れているかということを思い知らされました。
And so, of course, we heard from many people from throughout Japan, but for me particularly, hearing many different international voices and about the situation in many different countries around the world really made it very clear how we are indeed very delayed on many things in Japan, unfortunately, in taking these steps forward, not taking on or not being up to date with what we could say is the global common sense trends today.
10年前の福島をきっかけとして、世界は、人類の進むべき道は原発ではなく、そして、自然エネルギーを中心として、みんなが幸せに暮らせる世界を作ろうという方向に大きく方向転換をしました。
The Fukushima disaster of 10 years ago was indeed a great turning point for all of humanity to look at how we can move away from not nuclear power, but instead renewable energies and to create a future world in which all can experience happiness.
もちろん、世界の各国も簡単にその方向を転換ができたわけではありません。政治家の方々、財界の方々、そして市民の方々がさまざまな意見がありながら、熟議を重ねて、そして何がこの国の在り方にとって大切なのかをですね、決めていくことができた。まあ、そういうことをプロセスを見ておりますと、本当に素晴らしいなと思います。
And of course, this shift globally or in each and every country around the world is not something which happens easily. It's something which requires the different opinions, perspectives, and also deliberations of people from the worlds of politics, business, and of course, civil society as well. Really building upon thinking about what is important for each and every society and country. And we look at this process as, I think, something very key.
それに比べて、日本の国では、まあ、残念ながら、まあ、多くのですね、エスタブリッシュメントの方々が、すべて原発推進という方向にですね、まあ、取り込まれているという状況が続いております。特にマスコミという情報提供を公正に行うべき方々が、正しい情報というものを出してこない。この結果、日本国民がですね、かなり世論誘導されているということがよくわかります。
Unfortunately, if we compare the situation in Japan, however, we can see that it could be said the majority of people in the establishment are still today promoting nuclear power. We also see the issue of the media, for example, which should be conveying and portraying accurate information to people. But unfortunately, this is not the case. Therefore, many people are led by false information.
しかし、10年前のこの福島をまあ、きっかけとして国民の中でも本当にこのような形で良いのか、政治のことは政治家に、経済のことは財界に任せておいて本当に良いのだろうかという機運が盛り上がってきていることは事実だと思います。
However, at the same time, it is certain that from this turning point of the Fukushima disaster 10 years ago, many people here in Japan are really questioning whether we should accept the status quo, whether it's okay to leave political issues just up to politicians, business issues just up to business people. There is a real momentum for changing things here in Japan as well.
日本人は情緒の人々、感情の人々だと言われています。論理が弱いけれども、人の気持ちに、まあ、同調し共感する力は強いと言われています。福島の事件をきっかけとして、東北、特に福島の方々がいかに大変な思いをしているか、高齢者の方々、そして、子どもたちがいかにですね、大変な暮らしを強いられているかということを知るにつけて、これを何とかしていかなければいけないという気分が盛り上がってきているように思います。
So it is said that perhaps Japanese people or the tendency in society is not necessarily always to be so logical, but that people are really moved by emotion and have a deep sense of empathy as well. Therefore, it's very important for us to think of all of those who have been impacted by this disaster, of course, in all of the Tohoku northeastern region of Japan, but particularly in Fukushima, to think of the difficulties which were forced upon all people, but especially, for example, the elderly or children as well, and to recognize that we need to do something about it.
今回の高村さんによるバーチャルツアーをはじめ、福島の方々のですね、さまざまな思いを今回また改めて多くの方々が知ることができ、そして共感し、これを何とかしていかなければいけないというきっかけを作ったということで、今回のセミナーは大変大きな意味を持ったと思います。
So through today's program, of course, from Ms. Takamura and the virtual tour, but many other different voices and perspectives from people from Fukushima who were shared throughout the day, I think has really been an opportunity to people to be able to learn, to be able to feel, and to also look at how to take this into action as well. So I think this conference has been very meaningful.
そして、そうした日本をこれからどのように、新しい、方向に変えていくかということについて、世界の各国の方々が示唆してくださった今回の発言をみんなが共有してですね、そして日本においても同じことができるはずだ。そして国民がやはり中心となってですね、一人一人が自覚を持ってこの国を責任を持って担っていかなければいけない。それは政治家だけでなく、官僚だけでなく、財界だけでなく、多くの一般の国民、そして個人、そして小さな事業を営んでいる方々も含めてですね、そして高齢者から子どもに至るまで、みんながですね、一人ずつ責任を持った国民として、独立自尊という考え方でやっていかなければいけないということを、まあ、今回のですね、セミナーを通じて改めて考えた次第です。
And I think today has been a great opportunity for all of us, including here in Japan, to really hear the different perspectives and experiences from people around the world, and to realize that these kinds of change, these kind of shifts are indeed possible here as well. We can make change here in Japan, and that this should be people-centered as well. Everybody has their awareness of their own responsibility for the future. It is not something that we leave up to politicians, to bureaucrats, or to business people, but rather all citizens, all individuals, also even all small businesses, all small projects, the elderly, children, everybody, and each and every one of us has a responsibility and an action to take.
はい。日本は明治以来、立憲政治、まあ、立憲政治というのは国民が主体となってこの国を担っていくという政治を行ってきたはずですが、残念ながら福沢諭吉という、学者が強調、あるいは 教育家が強調していたように、日本人は、誰か人に頼ってそれに任せてしまえばいいという風潮がどうしても今までありました。
Since the Meiji times, Japan has said to be, you know, a constitutional country, which is based on having people as the agency within the country as well. But unfortunately, in the reality, as was stated by Fukuzawa as well, in Japan, we have this tendency of leaving things up to others, you know, to being dependent on official agencies and so on.
しかしこれからは本当に我々が自覚を持って、この国を原発のない安心して、生きることができる社会、そしてみんなが、幸せに、生きることができる社会、そしてみんなが責任を持って自分たちの国を、自分たちの社会を支えていくという、そういう自覚と思った社会に変えていかなければいけないと思っております。
However, I think from now, we, each and every one of us can be truly aware of the role that we play in creating our countries, our society's future together, for having a society which does not have nuclear power plants, which is safe for people to live in, where everybody can pursue and achieve happiness, and where each of us recognizes and knows our own responsibility for our society and for supporting this.
本日は、日本のトップリーダーであった内閣総理大臣5人がメッセージをいただき、また会場にもお越しになりました。この画面にもあります。
Today we actually had very special opportunity of messages from five of the former prime ministers of Japan, the top leaders of the country, and three who attended in person.
この他にも、例えば谷垣さんとか福田さんとか、多くの総理大臣経験者、トップリーダーの方々がいらっしゃると思いますが、おそらくは皆さん、この原発をゼロにして、そして自然エネルギーを中心とした社会を作ることについては、主義主張を問わず共通の思いだと思います。
And as well as these five figures, there are also many other top former prime ministers or other politicians in Japan, such as Mr. Tanigaki, Mr. Fukuda, who shared this vision of zero nuclear power here in Japan and a renewables-centered future as well. This is something which goes beyond any kind of political ideology.
まあ、実を申すと、このその二人は私の高校の先輩でもあります。
And actually, the two that I mentioned were my seniors in high school.
まあ、これはジョークでございます。
So that's a bit of a joke there.
まあ、それにしても、現役の総理大臣、ぜひですね、このような先輩たちが、示唆されていることを踏まえて、今の政治家の方々、総理大臣以下の方々がですね、ぜひ一度もう一回、この国の行く末をしっかりと考えて、原発のない安心して生きることができる自然エネルギー中心の日本国民が、そして世界が、喜ぶ経済発展、そして社会の発展を目指すような、そして思いやりを持って暮らせるような、そういう社会を作るように、今回の、セッションが、大きな役割を果たしてもらえば、私はこれに勝る喜びはないと思っています。
And I hope that this vision of the predecessors of former prime ministers of Japan can also be shared with the current prime minister and current politicians here in Japan as well, that they can reconsider the future direction of Japan, look at how we can create a country and indeed a world which has no nuclear power, which is safe and centered around renewables, and where we also have a considerate society, and also where we can have safe and considerate economic and social development. And I would be so happy if today has played some kind of a role towards that.
最後に、今回の、今回のシンポジウムを、お手伝いいただきました ICEP、FOE Japan、そしてピースボート、そして、最後まで司会のローを取っていただきました松村様をはじめ、そして最後に、最後まで この番組を聞いてくださった方々、そして参加してくださった方々、心からお礼を申し上げまして、閉会のご挨拶をさせていただきます。誠に本当にありがとうございました。
And finally, I would like to thank all of the organizations and individuals who were involved in creating today's conference, including ICEP, FOE Japan, Peace Boat, all of the staff involved, and of course, all of the audience and participants today as well. Thank you very much.
吉原さん、ありがとうございました。とても力強いメッセージでした。
Thank you so much for your strong message, Mr. Yoshiwara.
それではこのクロージングセッションも終わりに近づいてまいりましたけれども、実は原発ゼロ自然エネルギー100世界会議はこれで終わりではないんですね。
So we're coming to the end of the closing session, but actually this is not the very last program of today's conference.
この後8時より20時より Choose Life プロジェクトさんとのコラボレーションでエネルギーの未来は私たちが決めるが行われます。
And actually, after this, from 8 p.m. in Japanese time, there will be a program in collaboration with the Internet Media Choose Life Project. Unfortunately, this program will be only in Japanese language.
Yudai さんもこれにご登壇されると思いますけれども、簡単に紹介していただけますか?
And Yudai, I think you will be appearing in this program as well. Can you introduce it quickly?
はい、その通りです。この後8時から3名、4名の国会議員の皆さんと私を含める3人の若者で原発ゼロ、自然エネルギー100を実現するための政策というテーマをもと、ディスカッションしていきます。
Yes, that's right. Immediately after this, or from 8 p.m. Japan time, we will have a session with 4 members of the Japanese parliament and 3 youth leaders as well, discussing concrete policies for a nuclear-free and renewable Japan.
若い世代の視点からたくさん質問をしていきたいと思っています。
So I'm going to be giving lots of questions on behalf of the youth who are joining.
ありがとうございます。
そ
う
ですね。Thank you so much.
はい、雄大さんの発言もぜひ楽しみにしたいと思います。よろしくお願いします。
So we look forward to hearing that. Thank you very much.
それでは、そろそろクロージングセッションも終わりに近づいてきましたけれども、最後にお願いを申し上げます。このホームページの一番下の部分になりますが、この世界会議も企画、運営、準備ということで資金が発生しています。皆さんの温かいご支援をお待ち申し上げます。振り込み先もございますので、ぜひよろしくお願いいたします。
So we're coming to the end of the closing, but we have one final message. Of course, it takes a great amount of resources to pull together to plan and hold a conference such as this. So we'd like to ask if anybody is able to support, we would really appreciate any generous donations to help to cover and make today possible.
はい、それでは雄大さん、進もう。
原発ゼロ、自然エネルギー100の世界へ。
So thank you, and let's go together towards a zero nuclear, 100% renewable society.
ありがとうございました。今日の通訳ですが、ピースボートのメリージョイス、そして福島は吉川みちがお届けしました。さて、この企画には、たくさんの通訳の方々、そして、バックステージでサポートしてくれる技術者の人たちが、関わっています。
So thank you very much. Of course, to put together today's conference, there were many different backstage technical staff and also interpreters involved. The interpreters for this closing session were in Fukushima, Yoshikawa Michi, and in Tokyo, Mary Joyce.
そして日本各地、世界各地から登壇をしてくれた方々もいらっしゃいました。
And of course, many different speakers joining us from all over Japan and around the world.
そして、もう3000を超えるリツイートをしていただいた皆さんもいます。
And there were more than 3,000 people who retweeted a special program today as well.
その皆さんに参加していただいた全ての皆さんに感謝を申し上げたいと思います。
So thank you to everybody who joined the virtual protest being shown on the screen and all of the other programs throughout today.
ユダイさんもありがとうございました。
Thank you so much, ユダイ also.
それでは、皆さんありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. This brings us to a close.